It's time for kickoff on the new skin, BYU Sports Network. Live play-by-play coverage of BYU women's soccer is brought to you by Mountain America Credit Union, guiding you forward, Sagicor Life Insurance Company, Wise Financial Thinking for Life, Smith's, low prices, market fresh at Smith's, Wilner and O'Reilly, immigration solutions in Utah and abroad at WilnerO'Reilly.com, and by Zions Bank, we haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. Now for today's call, here's the voice of the Cougars, Greg Wrubell.
And before we get you our call and starting lineups, let's get a 10-second station identification on the new skin, BYU Sports Network.
This is BYU Radio on SiriusXM 143 and online at byuradio.org. Talk about good.
All right, with kickoff just moments away and starting lineups just around the corner, let's get to tonight's Sagicor Keys to the Game. And they are brought to you by Sagicor Life Insurance Company, Wise Financial Thinking for Life. And here are BYU's three keys for tonight. Key number one, get a strong start. Key number two, attack the space that Utah gives you. And key number three, execute on the press. With kickoff coming up, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. We'll start with the visiting BYU Cougars, coached by Jennifer Rockwood. 364 wins, 109 losses, 44 draws. Starting in goal for BYU and for Jen, number 18, Sabrina Davis. And so the Cougars have alternated keeper starts through now six matches. It's gone Cassidy Smith, Sabrina Davis, Cass and Sabs the next four ensuing. So through six matches, three full rotations at starting keeper. So Sabrina Davis in net for BYU. In this 4-1-3-2 for the Cougars, at left back and back in the starting 11 is Josie Gwynn. She's recovered from a shoulder injury. She played the last few games coming off the bench, and she'll get the start tonight at left back. So number 14, the sophomore Josie Gwynn at left back. The center backs, number 28, Alyssa Jefferson. Number 7, Danica Sarasio. And at right back, number 23, the 5'3" junior, number 23, Rachel Lyman. As the holding midfielder, playing the 6 is jersey number 10, Olivia Wade. The 3 midfielders in front of her, left to right, number 22, Bella Foligno, number 8, Michaela Coulihan, number 4, Lizzie Braby, and the two forwards across the top, left to right, number 5, Elise Flake, and number 21, Maddie Gates. That's your starting 11 for BYU. For Rich Manning and the Utah Utes, Coach Manning 172, 120, and 45 for his career record. This year's team is 1-2-1. BYU, by the way, is 2-2-1. And a 3-5-2 for Coach Manning, the way we look at things right now. In net, number 1, Carly Nelson. On the back line, number 3, Lulu Borges. Number 2, Tavia Leachman. Number 9, Aaliyah Gorder. Expect to see Gorder at center back. The 5 midfielders, number 20, Tatum Thornton. Number 17, Haley Stodden. Number 12, Holly DeGerda. Number 14, Polo Vanderveen. And number 5, Haley Kachikarney. Kachikarney and Ireland Dunn, we'll get to Dunn in a moment, were former teammates of Olivia Wade and Michaela Coulihan at Davis High School. Speaking of Ireland Dunn, number 21 is one of the two forwards for Utah, the other being number 19, Haley Skolmoski. And Skolmoski, with 23 career goals, leads the Utes in that category. So there you go, starting 11s for the Utes in red and the Cougars in dark blue to navy blue. So the uniforms for BYU tonight have both elements of the navy and the royal in them. And we're getting set to play. Greg Wrubell and Paige Barker with you at Ute Soccer Field here in Salt Lake City. And there's standing room, or sitting room only, if you will, on the berm to our left, the north here. And the stands are full across from us. And so a great environment to get this one underway. And Paige, as we talked about off the air and Jen mentioned on the air, most of the recent games here have been daytime affairs. So a nighttime game, Friday Night Lights here for BYU and Utah.
And you don't think that that would, maybe as a person watching, you wouldn't think that would play, have a factor in this game, but it does. I think it definitely does. Under the lights at a nighttime, there's a different energy. And so I'm excited to call it. And I wish, I really do wish that I could have played a nighttime game when back in my day, long, long time ago. It would have been fun.
One thing that makes it fun, regardless of time of day, is the kind of crowd you'll get here. And
yes,
it is a full house.
Yes.
And a lot of blue along with a lot of red. And so we anticipate an energized and intense environment here at Ute Soccer Field. Glad to have you along with us on BYU Radio, SiriusXM 143, ESPN 960 AM in Utah County, and online or on the app. So ever you're tuning into us, streaming, or catching us over the air, it is great to have you with us this evening. The officials for tonight's game. The referee is Jeff Arthur Holtz. The ARs are Karsten Gilwald and Robert Pickett. And the fourth official is Hamed Sadehi. BYU's keeper kit is the fluorescent green. Utah's keeper kit is gray and black, and the referees tonight are in yellow and black, and BYU will go left to right as we see it and you hear it. Defend the goal to our left, north to south come the Cougars in half number one, and BYU gets the opening touch with Maddie Gates playing backward to Rachel Lyman, and we are underway. Lizzie Braby on the near boundary. Centrally, Coulihan. Touchline, Lyman. One touch to Braby. Braby immediately to 40 yards down the barrel, stops the ball, rolls it to Coulihan. Coulihan from 25 tries a shot on frame that sails just wide right, and it'll be an early goal kick for Utah. And a nice little build-up from BYU in the first minute of the game.
Yeah, you love that energy. They got the ball wide on the right side, being already getting involved in the attack, and Lizzie with her speed just going up the gut, and Michaela gets a shot off in the first couple seconds of the game.
The sun diagonally in behind us, currently behind a cloud, and before long it'll be down for good, and the floodlights will do their job here at Ute Soccer Field. Right now, still some shadows on the pitch as we approach dusk here in Salt Lake City. And BYU with a possession on the far side of the pitch. Centrally, Olivia Wade at the halfway line. Plays it down the far boundary and deflected by Utah and out for a BYU throw. In the second minute of play, BYU and Utah scoreless and just underway here on the hill. And the Utes in the all reds, jerseys, shorts, and socks. And BYU in the all dark uniforms tonight. Bella Foligno lobs in off the chest of Elise Flake at the far side of the pitch. A stab at it by the Utes to put it in the BYU's defensive half, and they'll backline it to keeper Sabrina Davis. Back to Sarasio on the Pac-12 logo at the far side of the pitch. Sarasio down the far touchline. Josie Gwynn gets the start, accelerates into the attacking half. Plays it from left back to right back to Rachel Lyman. Lyman, Braby in the final third. Braby cuts a pass to Lyman, positioning for a cross. One-touch cross off the midsection of a Ute in the 18. Settles to Gates. Gates tees up Braby. Braby tries a shot that's blocked back at her to the top of the penalty D, and Utah now in possession. And the first real Utah possession of the match comes here in the third minute. Down the left wing, Ireland Dunn on the run. Former Davis High School product. Former teammate of a couple of Cougars. Plays it to the top of the 18. Intercepted there by her former teammate, Olivia Wade. Wade leading Lizzie Braby down the right sideline. Braby catching up to it at the touchline. Steps around her defender. Braby, a second defender, wins it from Lizzie. Lizzie taps it away, and now Utah comes away in possession. Well tackled by Gates. Gates wins it back for BYU, tracks it down the near chalk. Lays off Lyman at the halfway line. She plays backward to Jefferson at center back. Alyssa in control in the Cougars' defensive half here in the third minute. 0-0 BYU at Utah.
Utah not putting a ton of pressure on BYU right now. They're just possessing along their back four, nice and easy.
Lyman at the center stripe. Space into the final third. Sends it wide to Braby. Braby kills the ball, looks centrally, plays to Coulihan, intercept by the Utes, drives it again into BYU's defensive half. And it's a defensive mindset for Utah as they've settled back here in the early moments of this match. BYU with a misplay to the far boundary and out for a Utah throw. So the Utes will get a throw in the Cougars' attacking half, and now the fourth minute of play. Utah coming in two tonight, 1-2-1, 0-1 here at home. BYU 2-2-1, and in three away matches, they are 1-1-1. Win at Fullerton, draw at Nebraska, loss at Texas A&M. A&M's turned into a tremendous team in the early going, undefeated and ranked number 5 nationally. BYU's played number 5 and number 1 and taken 2-0 setbacks against both. That number 1 team is Stanford as a misplay from Sarasio sailed over the head of Lyman to the near touchline. It'll be another Utah throw in the Cougs' defensive half and a lob in for the Utes, Haley Stodden. Stodden hops it to Dunn. Dunn back to Stodden on the touchline. Intercepted there by Braby. Won the ball nicely. And now a four-player battle that goes to Utah for the time being. A play to the halfway line. A drive into the attacking third for the Utes. Off the boot of Aaliyah Gwerter. And Alyssa Jefferson will play it. Deflected, but to her teammate Olivia Wade. Wade plays it to the neutral third. Stepping up. Gwerter, the play ahead to Dunn on the left wing. Dunn comes laterally. Still dribbling. Intercepted by Coulihan. Coulihan sending Elise Flake through. One on two for Elise. To her right, putting it to her right foot, a shot and right at the keeper, moving slightly to her right. is Carly Nelson to make the save on Elise Flake. Elise Flake tried it from the top of the box with a right-footed shot that is saved in the fifth.
That was a quick attack by BYU. Michaela Coulihan won the ball kind of at the center of the field, and then a quick ball to Elise, and then Elise with her speed, she just turns and she goes, creates herself an opportunity and a shot. Good luck for BYU.
Elise Flake with 8 career goals, 2 of them coming this season, and both coming last Saturday against Idaho State. Danica Sarasio in the Cougars' defensive third, a misplay to the middle third, and Utah plays into Cougars' defensive half, deflected back into the Utes' defensive half of the pitch, and they play long and right and to the boundary where it's tracked down by Josie Gwynn. Gwynn down the far touchline, plays it on the boundary to Foligno. Foligno backlines it to Sarasio. Danica Sarasio for BYU builds from the back. Over the top for Maddie Gates. Too far for Maddie. It'll skip all the way into the 18, handled cleanly there by Carly Nelson. She'll bowl it out to her left in the 6th minute of play and plays Gwerter. Gwerter, left wing Stodden. Centrally to Holly DeGerda. DeGerda to Ireland Dunn. Back to DeGerda at the center circle. DeGerda flips the pitch from left to right. Tavia Leachman plays down the right wing. Through ball down the right for the Utes. A cross coming in off the feet of Alyssa Jefferson, and she's fouled in the 18. Foul on Utah. Free kick for BYU coming in the Cougars' defensive penalty area.
That was Utah's first, you could say, dangerous play, going in the right side of the pitch, up the flank, trying to create a cross opportunity, but then a foul on Alyssa. A little burst from Utah there.
Was Tatum Thornton down that right wing in the attack. As off the goal kick, with shadows lengthening on the pitch here at Ute Soccer Field. BYU playing it into the sun. As any sun that Sabrina Davis will have to deal with will be here in the first half.
Yeah.
So Utah's keeper playing with the sun at her back. As a throw in for the Utes at the far side of the pitch comes to the halfway line, settled there by Skolmoski. Haley Skolmoski's fouled. And a free kick for Utah, the result, in the circle. Utes will set it up 10 yards to their side of half. And Lulu Borges, the tall backliner, will play it short to her backline mate, Aaliyah Gwerter. Gwerter ahead to DeGerda. Gwerter, DeGerda, and Borges triangulate as they go to Leachman, far side of the pitch at right back. Tavia Leachman settles at the halfway stripe. Plays on the right wing to Thornton. Centrally, Skolmoski. Skolmoski wanted to send Pola Vanderveen through, but the pass was heavy and goes all the way to Sabrina Davis in her goal box. She handles and gets ready to distribute here in the 8th minute. BYU and Utah scoreless here at Ute Soccer Field. BYU Women's Soccer brought to you in part by Fillmore Spencer, Utah Valley's largest top-rated law firm. They can play offense, defense, or provide a little coaching. Fillmore Spencer, solving problems and seizing opportunities for you, your family, and your business. Utes possess in their defensive half. Ireland Dunn dribbling around Lyman. Second defender Coulihan takes it away from Dunn and is fouled in the process. Free kick for BYU from 55 yards angle right. So Michaela aggressively to the ball and won the foul on the hip check. Sarasio, left back Gwynn. Gwynn off a hard settle was dispossessed, and Utah now looking at a 3-on-2 into BYU's defensive half. Thornton plays across off the head of Jefferson toward the far boundary, and now it'll be a Utah throw deep in the Utes' final third as we're in the 9th minute. BYU and Utah, zeros at Ute Soccer Field.
BYU needs to be careful there. If Utah had a little bit more energy and a bigger burst, then that would have been, like you said, a 3v2, and that could have been a goal opportunity for sure.
Thornton will throw about 10 yards from the end line. Throws toward the flag. Off the boot of Vanderveen back to Thornton. Errant pass by Utah. Interception by BYU. Coulihan ahead to Flake. Flake in the middle third. Elise Flake now. Past the halfway line. Centrally, Coulihan. 50 yards away straight away. Plays to the right wing at 30 to Lizzie Braby. Braby stops the ball. Sends Lyman down the right flank. A return ball to Braby. Braby tried to nutmeg DeGerda. They get it away from her. Dribbles a second defender. Braby at the upper right penalty elbow, played the Gates. Gates put a pop on it, but just up in the air where Carly Nelson could handle it. So as the ball settles into Nelson's arms in the 10th minute, she gets ready to drop kick or punt away in a scoreless match.
BYU in their attack, they need to be a little bit more fluid. Lizzie had the ball close to the 18 and kind of stopped it, just dead stopped the ball, and that kind of slows the energy. They need to have a little bit more fluidity to their attack.
Utah coming into tonight with a relatively low shot conversion percentage, 7.7%, four goals on 52 shots. BYU almost double that at 13.1% with 13 goals on 99 shots. No goals yet. Olivia Wade sees some pressure from Paula Vanderveen and backlines it to Alyssa Jefferson. Jefferson to her center back mate Sarasio. Danica Sarasio just outside of her penalty area. Lead ball to Wade. Return ball right to Sarasio here in the 11th. Far boundary Gwynn. Gwynn gets the start after having recovered from a shoulder injury suffered at Nebraska. Nice ball to Coulihan on the Ute logo in the circle. Coulihan, 50 yards away straight away. Ropes it on the floor to Gates. Gates shielding and a miscommunication, but chasing it down near boundary is Lyman. Rachel double teamed, back lines at Jefferson. Alyssa Jefferson played a loose ball to Braby. Braby, Lyman in front of the Ute team area on the right boundary. Nice dribble by Lyman. Plays across to the top of the 18, headed clear by Borges, popped high in the air by DeGerda, and chested down by Paula Vanderveen in the Ute midfield. Plays Ireland Dunn. Dunn lays off Stodden. And Stodden in a defensive third with some BYU pressure. Placed at the back line. Back line goes over the top for Skolmoski. Skolmoski chests it down in front of Alyssa Jefferson. Skolmoski getting it to her right. Got tripped up. Play on. And the ball goes to Josie Gwynn. Lead ball Olivia Wade. Wade in the center circle. Liv past the halfway line. Ahead to Flake. Flake was hip checked out of the way. Couldn't receive the pass. Now does track it down and plays Coulihan. Coulihan down the barrel at 45 yards. Michaela stumbling. Gets around a defender. Michaela through to Gates. Gates right side of the penalty area. Crossing to the six, but deflected out by Utah. And it's a Mountain America Credit Union corner kick for BYU. Brought to you by Mountain America. Guiding you forward. So BYU corner from the attacking right flag here in the 12th minute. And for the Cougars, and that will be corner number 23, which evens the ledger on the year. BYU's taken 23 and conceded 23. So from the attacking right flag, Lizzie Braby will send it in. Right-footed and out swinging. And directionally wayward as it went over the crossbar back of the goal. And so no opportunity there as Braby, not normally the corner kick taker, sent it out of bounds.
Yeah, you hate to have that happen with a goal-scoring opportunity. Corners are definitely a chance to put a ball in the back of the net, especially for BYU.
Stodden, centrally, Dunn. Dunn gave it away to Foligno. Foligno gave it right back to Utah's back line. A little too impatient there for Bella. Had space, had time, and had teammates. Leachman at right back. Utes playing their defensive third, and again with some BYU press. Mm-hmm. One of Jen's keys to the game was execute that press, and in the 13th minute, BYU with a steady presence to challenge the Utes back line when in possession. Leachman, centrally Skolmoski. Skolmoski around Coulihan to the attacking half. Plays Thornton on the right wing. Thornton sees it deflected out by BYU. It'll be a Utah throw directly across from us. Our vantage point is almost very near the halfway line as the BYU team area is to our left and the Utah team area to our right. We're slightly above pitch level and an elevated platform here at Utah at Ute Soccer Field. Utes throw in. Loose ball battle won by Olivia Wade. Plays it to the circle where a step up keeps it in Utah possession by Borges. Well done by Lulu as she plays with her back to goal and back lines it to Kachikarni. Kachikarni and Gwerder now build from the back for Utah. They play it long and left for Dunn. Stabbed out of the air by BYU. Headed by Skolmoski to the feet of Sarasio. And now loose ball in the neutral third. Tracked down by the Utes. DeGerda intercepted to Gates. Gates at the halfway line. To her left, lead ball Braby. Braby straight away at 40 yards. Slows it and lays it off to Gwynn in the attacking half. Josie comes to 40. Plays Flake at 35. A soft touch to Coulihan. Coulihan takes the 1-2 from Gates. Tried to get a shot off from 25 yards, but couldn't get a clean look at it as the Utes intercept and play to the neutral third. Skolmoski, Vanderveen. Vanderveen, Dunn on left wing. Utah into the attacking half. Dunn takes Lyman down the flank. Plays to the top of the area. Skips all the way to the far side of the 18. Settled there by Thornton. Plays to Skolmoski at 25 yards. A chip high in the air. Bounces to Vanderveen, foul on Utah as Livia Wade was upended. So the Utah foul and a BYU free kick from the top of their penalty area in the 15th minute. BYU and Utah scoreless. Greg Rubel and Paige Barker with you at Ute Soccer Field. BYU Women's Soccer is brought to you by Utah Community Credit Union, the number one mortgage provider in Utah Valley, with home buying experts at work in every branch. So if you're thinking of buying or refinancing a home, talk to us. It's what we do. BYU with Olivia Wade in possession. Defensive half to middle half. Gwynn tried to find Flake in the final third. Pass didn't find its target, but the Utes deflect back to Gwynn, who plays Coulihan. Coulihan, Flake, 35 yards straight away. Sandwiched by two Utah defenders, they take it away from Flake. And DeGerda will play back line. From back line to Utah's, or to BYU's back line. Jefferson, Wade. Wade on the floor to Flake. Flake trying to get possession for a shot and just couldn't tee it up in time at the top of the 18. As the Utes poke it loose and play toward the boundary, it'll be a BYU throw here in the 16th.
That was a quick turn by Elise at the top of the 18. Utah needs to be sure to be tight on her because she doesn't need a lot of space to create herself an opportunity there.
Quite breezy about an hour or so ago, but the winds have calmed substantially, and a very peaceful night now at Ute Soccer Field here on the hill in Salt Lake City. Beautiful night, a Friday evening preceding a BYU football game on Saturday night. We'll have the Cougars and Cal tomorrow on the network. Still early in this one. BYU two shots, both on frame, both saved by Carly Nelson. There have been five fouls, four against Utah, and the only corner has been taken by BYU. We're in the 17th minute of a scoreless match. Alyssa Jefferson plays a 30-yard ball to Foligno. Foligno now playing on the right wing, normally left. Bella down the right flank, across to the top of the 18. It skips to Flake. Flake had to settle and was intercepted as she tried to put that ball to her boot. Gwynn will play out at the far boundary, kept in by Lizzie Braby. Braby and Foligno have switched wings right now for BYU. Braby coming centrally and gets the ball away to Coulihan. Coulihan is tackled. Play on, says the official. Lead ball to Vanderveen. Pola Vanderveen leading a 3-on-4 for Utah into the Utes attacking half. Lyman intercepts. Plays Wade, and Wade gave away. What do we have? We have a whistle. I think another foul on Utah. A fifth Utah foul. I believe that was the call. Maybe a tug or an obstruction there, as it'll be BYU free kicking in the 18th minute now of a scoreless match. Defensive half play from Jefferson to Sarasio. Sarasio all the way across the pitch to Gwynn, and Gwynn ahead to Braby at left wing. So Braby and Foligno have switched spots at midfield from right to left and left to right respectively, as Josie Gwynn at left back goes center back Sarasio here in the 18th. Long ball, near side, Lyman. Nice settle by Rachel, and a lead to Foligno. Foligno looking to send Gates through. Gates collects at the right elbow of the penalty area. Kills the ball, puts her back to goal, plays to Lyman. Lyman tries a shot that sails wide right from a good 20 yards in the 18th minute.
BYU, they're having really good build-ups, especially from Rachel Bingham, getting it wide, getting it up. Where they're finding a little bit of trouble is that, you say it, Greg, correctly, they kill the ball at the top of the 18, and that just totally slows the momentum down. They need to keep that ball moving and take early shots. I think they're taking one too many touches inside the 18, and then Utah's just collapsing on them. So it just needs to be quicker and less touches.
Almost halfway through, half number one, Greg Rubel and Paige Barker with you here in Salt Lake City. Jefferson laces it down the right boundary to the back line of Utah, to the center line of the pitch. Vanderveen plays to the circle to Kachikarni. Haley Kachikarni coming down the barrel against BYU. Plays it wide right, targeting Tatum Thornton. Thornton couldn't settle it. It goes off her thigh and out for a BYU throw in the Cougars' defensive third. 31st meeting between BYU and Utah. And BYU's held the series advantage over the years. ...21-7-2 is the Cougars' edge over the Utes historically. Last two matches here, a Utah win in 2014, a BYU win in 2016. Sprinting into the attacking half and final third now is Michaela Coulihan. Coulihan rounding defenders, playing to Foligno. Foligno's shot is blocked back to Bella. And Bella, in a layoff attempt to Lyman, sees it intercepted by the Utes. Double teamed is Stodden and taken away by Lyman. The play to Wade. Wade, 10-yard ball to Coulihan. Ooh. Coulihan tried to 1-2 it back to Liv. Liv got a toe to it, but Utah intercepting before Wade could really control it. Skolmoski at the halfway line. Skolmoski to Vanderveen. Vanderveen sent Ireland Dunn through. Flag is down. Dunn into the 18. A shot parried wide by Sabrina Davis. That shot may or may not have found the inside of the frame, but Sabrina taking no chances, diving to her right and parries that ball wide. But a quick through ball to Ireland Dunn. And Dunn, the left-footed shot that made Sabrina Davis work and dive to her right. So a corner kick for Utah here. Mountain America Credit Union corner kick coming in the 20th minute. Mountain America Credit Union guiding you forward. It'll come from the attacking left. And Pola Vanderveen will take it. The Dutch native will have a left-footed outswinger here now in the 21st minute of a scoreless match. Raises both arms, drops them, boot to ball, far post, headed high in the air by Kachikarni. A second header is down toward the end line and played down the byline by Danica Sarasio, kept in by Utah. It goes far post the other way, left side. Vanderveen off a deflection in the six, sees a header go toward frame, and Sabrina Davis has to dive to her right outside the goalpost to collect. So moments of threat there for Utah. And BYU nerves had to be steady there as Utah kept the ball in the 18 and the 6 for a good 30 seconds of play before finally Sabrina Davis would dive to her right and collect, and now distributes on a drop kick into the attacking half for BYU. 21st minute, 0-0. Lizzie Braby nods down, chases down toward the boundary. It goes out. It'll be a Utah throw. Braby and Foligno have switched back their wings. Foligno back on the left and Braby on the right now. Utah throw by Aaliyah Gorder off the chest of Ireland Dunn. Vanderveen, DeGerda, DeGerda, Skolmoski at the halfway line. Chips a pass to Kachikarni. Kachikarni into the attack. Plays Thornton down the right flank. Tatum Thornton, a one-touch cross. Right into the legs of Sarasio on the defensive 18 for BYU. Sarasio ahead to Flake as BYU's on the counter now. Elise Flake is tackled, and the ball out at the far boundary off DeGerda. DeGerda diving into Elise and playing it out for a BYU throw. And the sun is almost behind us now, as the shadows have left the pitch and the floodlights illuminate the grass here at Ute Soccer Field. BYU throws into Foligno. Foligno backlines it, Sarasio. 22nd minute, almost halfway through half number one. Lyman onto a long ball right, toe tap right to Braby down the right wing. Gorder to it first. Braby does well to win it back. Plays Lyman, quickly challenged. Plays Lizzie. Lizzie, pass to Ute defender Ireland Dunn. Dribbling away from her and backlining it to Jefferson at the center stripe to Braby on the right wing. Centrally, Alyssa. Alyssa takes that lead ball, runs it to 30 yards, plays Gates at the top of the 18. Maddie Gates trying to get it to her left. Plays to Flake. Flake, a left-footed shot that's wide left. Almost curled in that far post for a 1-0 lead as we hit the halfway mark of the first half. Elise Flake with a quick turn and left-footed shot, and just outside the left post, it'll be a goal kick for Utah on the 23rd.
It was so quick that I don't even think her hips got all the way around the ball. I don't know how she got that shot off because she wasn't even turned all the way around. But top of the 18, quick turn, shot. Oh, I thought that was in. I gasped.
Just didn't quite have the curl and bend needed to tuck it in that left post. Keeper couldn't have done anything about it, and
no.
It was almost that good a shot. Just outside the post, goal kick for Carly Nelson.
And it had power.
Goal kick knotted down in the circle, and a push is called on Olivia Wade, so foul on BYU. Seventh foul of the match, only second against the Cougars, and Utah will get a free kick from a good 55 yards away, almost straight away, here in the 24th minute. The last of the shadows lengthen here as the sunset is moments away. We'll see our first sub of the match forthcoming. It'll be a Utah sub as Michaela Christensen will check in. And off that free kick, a glancing header that goes over the crossbar and wide left. And that was Tavia Leachman latching onto the end of it. So a free kick from 55 yards, put it in the mixer.
Yeah.
And Utah got ahead to it as three Ute subs check in. Max Flom, Michaela Christensen, and Emali McKinnon, all going to check in now for Coach Rich Manning. So three in, three out here in the 25th minute. And Coach Manning told me before the match that he'd be using some players that were not very frequently used so far, and so it is that Emali McKinnon, having played only one match of the four, checks in here in the 25th of a scoreless match. BYU and Utah zeros here at Ute Soccer Field. BYU Women's Soccer brought to you by Zions Bank. Zions Bank, we haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. Utah to the top of the 18. A shot that's handled by Sabrina Davis falling to her right. So Utah a little more threat right now as Michaela Christensen, having checked in, plays a shot on frame that Sabrina Davis had to handle. BYU a bit on its back foot right now.
Yeah. They need to clean it up in the back line for sure. Play quicker and just keep it simple. Just find
Olivia
their game
Wade
again.
On the intercept. Wade into the attacking half. Olivia, slow ball, plays a five-yard pass to Michaela Coulihan. Coulihan to Lyman on the right wing. Back to Michaela. Michaela's got space. She gets into that space, trying to set up a left-footed shot from 25 yards. Won't be able to take it as the Utes tackle and win the ball away from Michaela and are in possession. So Michaela trying to get deep. Couldn't quite get there as Skolmoski and Jefferson collide on a long ball played for Skolmoski that BYU handled with Jefferson. And the official gave it a play on. Ultimately, BYU possession back line with Lyman. Lyman at right back here in the 26th minute of a scoreless match. Comes to the center circle. Plays Foligno. BYU's yet to sub. Utah's brought in three just moments ago. Foligno, Wade at the halfway line. 30-yard ball played for Flake. Utah winning away from Flake. Popping it high in the sky. Coulihan and DeGerda collide. The ball settles to BYU. Gwynn, Foligno, left side of the pitch. Left back Gwynn sprinting to the attacking half. Final third plays Gates. Gates one touch. Gates putting it to her left. Gates into the 18. A touch by Utah to take it toward the byline. And it'll be a foul on Maddie Gates, I believe, right toward the goal line. So free kick for Utah here in the 27th. And the shots have evened up in a hurry, and the shots on goal now favor Utah. Four apiece on shots, 3-2 shots on goal in the Utes' favor. The last 10 minutes or so, I think, belong to Utah. Give BYU the first 15 and Utah the last 10 as we're now in the 27th minute. Over the top for Michaela Christensen. To it is Seracio, and Seracio plays it out of danger to Foligno. BYU now a chance to counter. Foligno, Wade, and across the pitch from center to right to Jefferson. Jefferson, Braby. Braby one-touch swing to Lyman. Lyman on the near touchline. Lyman gets a defender to fall. Works around her into the attacking half. Plays Braby at 30 yards. Braby stops the ball. First defender handled. Second defender got her, DeGerda.
She can't stop the ball. They've stopped it every time at the top of the 18, and then Utah collapses.
Wide right come the Utes, and now centrally with Flom. Flom lays off Kachikarni and plays Tatum Thornton down the far wing. Thornton, right side of the 18, got into the penalty area. Played across off the foot of Jefferson and out, but settles to DeGerda at 30 yards. DeGerda tackled by Coulihan. No whistle. BYU now 3-on-3 the other way. Coulihan down the middle has Gates to her right. Gates calling for the ball. Michaela's still with it. Tries a shot that's blocked.
Waited too long. Waited a little bit too long. One or two touches too long.
Lizzie Braby is yanked, and a foul is called and easily spotted there on McKinnon. Amalie McKinnon fouling Lizzie Braby. It's a free kick for BYU from 40 yards and a quick retake as Jefferson plays Lyman. Lyman gets across to the far post. Over the byline, last touch by Utah. It'll be a Mountain America Credit Union corner kick for BYU. Brought to you by Mountain America, guiding you forward as Jen Rockwood goes to the bench for her first two subs. Former Ute Ella Ballstedt is in, along with Cameron Tucker. So Ballstedt and Tucker in. Braby and Flake are out in the 29th minute. It'll be a BYU corner kick coming from the attacking left, and they may give Ballstedt this corner. So the former Ute Ella, having just checked in, will go to the attacking left flag to send in on the corner. It's a Mountain America Credit Union corner in the 29th. Ballstedt with a right-footed in-swinger goes short instead to Gwynn at the penalty area elbow. Lays off Seracio at 30 yards. Danica got it into the 18, but just a slow rolling shot that Nelson can handle with her feet. Those last two subs coming in are Zions Bank substitution. Zions Bank, we haven't forgotten, who keeps us in business. So BYU's not done much with his two corners here in the first half.
No, I'm not a huge fan of short corners just because you have a free cross. So in my mind, take it and put it inside the 18.
Almost a third of the way done as we're in the 30th minute. Loose ball battle in the middle third, won by Foligno. Foligno centrally Wade. Overlapping down the right comes Rachel Lyman. Lyman played out, couldn't keep it in on the boundary. So a Utah throw here in the 30th.
BYU needs to get a good shot off. They need to create something right now because they're a little flat, and Utah has the momentum right now.
Moments ago, a nice 3-on-3 developing, and with Maddie Gates down the right wing, Michaela tried a shot that was blocked, and that was the best last good chance for BYU as Lyman takes a knock and goes down as the ball's played ahead to Gates at 25 yards. Tees up Coulihan to 30. Michaela putting it to her left. A shot comes from well outside the 18, deflects to Gates. Gates trying to get a head on it, and it just skips harmlessly to Nelson in the 6. Not a clean look by Maddie off a bouncing ball in the 31st.
And that was a hard ball to handle, too. Maddie had 2 Utes on her, and it was head high, hard to control.
Utes play down the right wing to Christensen. Takes a bump, and off a ricochet, ends up in possession. Plays Flom down the right wing. Max Flom is dispossessed by Seracio. The play out for a Utah throw in the 31st to 0-0. BYU and Utah go into the latter stages of the opening half. As dusk has arrived here along the Wasatch Front, Josie Gwynn racing past the halfway line, dribbling it centrally and playing centrally to Cam Tucker. Tucker does a 360 with the ball. Gets down the barrel, tries a right-footed shot that will fall right into the midsection of Carly Nelson. Had a little heat on it, but right at the keeper for Cam Tucker. Save made in the 32nd.
Yeah, and we love her speed. She got that ball at half and then turned around, did a 360, and just booked it right at the Utah back line and created a shot. And that's what BYU needs right now. Just create your own space and get your shot off.
Attacking half play for the Utes with Michaela Christensen.
Great
intercepted by Josie Gwynn. Gwynn stepping into the passing lane, taking it away, playing to Gates in the middle third off the feet of Gates, the head of Coulihan, and a step up nod down by Tavia Leachman to win the ball just for a moment as Josie Gwynn then stepped up and played out for BYU. More substitutions for Coach Rich Manning. Anna Escobedo will be checking in for Utah along with Kristen Fairbairn. And again, Fairbairn seldom used to this point in the season as Skolmoski and McKinnon will check out. Fairbairn's played a little more than most. This will be her 4th of 5, so just the one game she missed was last game. Foul by BYU in the middle third. It'll be a Utah free kick here in the 33rd. Defender prepares to take. It's actually Vanderbeen coming back to the back line to play the free kick. She'll play up top, or farther up top. Free kick from nearly 60. Gets into the 18. Off of Utah head Leachman, caught by Sabrina Davis. So Utah's had 2 long free kicks, 55 to 60 yards, and both have resulted in headers either on frame or just wide of frame. Foligno played under the feet of Tucker into the back line of Utah. Utah in the center circle now with Kachikarni. Kachikarni, Vanderveen. Hola Vanderveen. Left wing, Fairbairn. Fairbairn slipped and fell as she tried to evade Bella Foligno. Got the ball to her teammate DeGuerda. DeGuerda goes back line to Guerder. Guerder sees pressure from Cam Tucker. The pass to Borges was wayward, but Borges tracks it down and finds Leachman at right back. And then Tavia Leachman played out, a misplay by Utah. And a throw in for BYU in the 34th minute. Zeros on the board. In this match, I guess, considering the ebbs and flows, is more or less been evenly played here in the first half between both sides.
Yeah, it has. And I think both teams also need to possess a little bit more. I think they've connected at least 1 or 2 passes, but they need to keep it more. They need to keep the ball moving.
Start coming.
Escobedo pressures Sabrina Davis into a pass to Lyman. Lyman didn't handle it. And Lyman on the giveaway to Escobedo. Utah gives it right back. They did retain possession. Vanderveen to Christensen. Christensen's going to get a shot off. And a stabbing intercept by Olivia Wade. Well done by BYU to end that Utah possession near the top of the 18. Olivia Wade now into the attacking half. Plays it left wing, Maddie Gates. Gates approaches the penalty area, puts it to her right, tries a shot that takes a skip off a deflection. It just bounces to Carly Nelson. No trouble for the Utah keeper in the 35th. Need more quality attempts.
Yeah, exactly. That's the perfect word, quality attempts, because we're getting these shots off, but we haven't really tested the keeper. At least had one maybe that had power on it and it went wide.
Utah sees backline pressure. Fairbairn to Kachikarni. Kachikarni sends it high in the sky off the head of Jefferson, glancing nod on by Coulihan, and a head down by Utah in the Utes attacking half. Vanderveen flips the pitch from left to right to Max Flom. Flom settles at 40 yards. Plays Escobedo through, tried to find her through, but Seracio sniffed it out and played down the touchline, but right to Utah. Utah takes the interception into the final third off a deflected shot toward frame. It bounces to Sabrina Davis. Kind of a funky little hop there. Forced Sabrina, a shorter keeper, to have to jump to control it. That was a nothing shot, but off a deflection and a funny bounce made Sabrina work for it. BYU now in the attacking half. Some nice 1-2-3 pass combinations to Tucker. Tucker racing past the defender. Tucker getting it to 30 yards. Ball stopped by Utah. Back to Cam. Cam settles the ball. Tees up Coulihan at 40 yards right down the barrel. Coulihan, 10-yard ball to Cam. Cam to 25 yards. Can she get a right-footed shot off? No, it's blocked to Borges. Borges plays midfield Vanderveen. Vanderveen hounded by Wade. And BYU wins it thanks to Wade and Coulihan. Michaela now with the ball top of the penalty area. Takes it wide herself right toward the end line. Fairbairn is there and played out for a BYU throw near the attacking right flag. Substitutions here in the 36th for BYU. Zions Bank substitutions brought to you by Zions Bank. We haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. Shea Redding in for Josie Gwynn at left back. And McKaylee Moore is in for Maddie Gates at forward. So two in, two out for BYU here in the 36th. Less than 10 to go here in the first half of a scoreless match. Throw in for Rachel Lyman near the attacking right flag to our right as BYU goes left to right as we see it and you hear it. The sun is down. Shadow's gone here at Ute Soccer Field. Lyman throws in to Coulihan. Coulihan is hounded and jockeyed from behind. Played out by Utah. Lyman will throw in again. Lyman skips it to Tucker at the right side of the penalty area. The play to Coulihan, a touch to Lyman. Lyman tried to get the ball to Wade. Ricocheted off of Utah and the Utes in possession. Vanderveen sends Flom down the right wing. Ute fans sense a counter coming as Escobedo's intercepted. Nice poke away by Danica Seracio. Ahead to Moore. Moore, Ballstedt. Ella. Body check by her former squad and at the far boundary out off of Utah for a BYU throw. Might have been Flom that got her, former teammate. As Ella played 2 years for Utah, now has two at BYU. Looking at her. They actually said it was not out, rather the foul. So they called the body check for an actual foul on Utah. It'll be a BYU free kick from 50 yards, angle left. Free kick played to the top of the penalty area. Off ahead and wide right, tracked down by Fairbairn. Plays out for a BYU throw in the 38th. So it was evidently off of Utah head last as they played out. And BYU throws.
That was a good ball by Danica. She got it into the 18. BYU just needs to be a little more aggressive in the 18 and win those head balls.
Lyman throws 10 yards from the end line to our right. Gets it to the top of the area. Settled by Foligno to the feet of Coulihan. Coulihan dispossessed. Another BYU throw on the near boundary. BYU Women's Soccer brought to you by Sagicor Life Insurance Company. Sagicor, wise financial thinking for life. From the goal line, McKaylee Moore is tackled and out off of Utah. It'll be a BYU corner kick, a third corner for BYU. It comes here in the 39th minute. It'll be from the attacking right flag, and Cameron Tucker, the preferred corner kick taker, will take. This is another Mountain America Credit Union corner kick brought to you by Mountain America, guiding you forward. So Cam lines it up. Attacking right flag, right-footed out swinger. Raises her right arm, drops it. Right boot to ball.
Oof.
Well past the far post and all the way to the far touchline. Can Olivia Wade get to it before it goes out? Yes, she does. Nope. No, she doesn't. Just snuck over the chalk. So it'll be a Utah throw, and so none of BYU's three corners have given BYU any real look at goal.
Yeah, and partially...
Utah subs with Vanderveen checking out and entering for the Utes, Jessica Hickson here in the 39th page.
I was just saying the corner kicks, why they haven't been successful is the delivery. Ultimately, that delivery went way past 18. Another one didn't even make it onto the pitch. So just need to be driven balls inside the 18.
So of the three corners, one out of bounds, one all the way across the pitch out of bounds, and one short that resulted in no real attempt. 40th minute, 0-0. Fairbairn, near side, centrally catch a Carney. Good tackle by Coulihan, who then takes a hip check and she goes flying.
No. Thank you.
They'll say that Coulihan touched last, and you heard that Utah opposing the initial call, which was a BYU throw. He said, no, I don't think he got that one right. Ref says, right you are, and we'll give it to Utah. So Utah throw here in the 40th. BYU's used six different starting lineups in six games. And they've alternated keepers every game. Sabrina Davis got the start tonight. Nice nod down by Michaela Coulihan to Cameron Tucker. Tucker at 40 yards angle right. Comes centrally with it.
Too long.
Many red shirts in front of her and ultimately poked away and over the boundary for another BYU throw here in the 41st.
It's weird because BYU, they're going up the gut every time. They're trying to dribble into the back, the Ute back line. They need to use their width. They need to get end line and create crosses.
BYU is currently in its dead zone. They have no goals scored in minutes 41-50 this year. So if they're to score here on either the final 5 minutes of this half or the first five of the second half, it'd be the first goal in that time frame. As there's scoreless in minutes 41-50, and we're in minute 41 right now. Jefferson from 30 yards comes to the center part of the park, still on the ball. Plays wide right to Ballstedt. Ballstedt not going to make it to the goal line before it goes over for a Utah goal kick here in the 41st. So zeros on the board. And the Idaho State game last Saturday was the only game this season in which BYU has scored a first half goal, and they scored four of them.
Yeah, and they were beautiful goals, too. But tonight, BYU hasn't had as good of looks, even. They've had some shots, but like we said, they haven't been testing the keeper at all. And they just need to keep their energy high. It's kind of died a little bit.
Goal kick, Carly Nelson. Flicked on by Katja Carney. Tracking it down is Shea Redding. Redding plays it off of Escobedo. Escobedo on a bit of a stabbing intercept toward the byline. Collects it, is then tackled by Redding. Redding got back to it and won it back for BYU. Gave it to Utah's back line, Leachman. Leachman down the far paint. Knotted down by Hickson. Kept in by Hickson. Hickson plays across. Ricochets in the 18 and out to Olivia Wade. Wade Moore. Moore gave it away in a position of threat to Christensen. And a shot parried over the crossbar as it came from the Utes at the top of the 18. And that was a costly giveaway as Escobedo played the shot on frame. And Sabrina Davis well to parry over, but BYU giving the ball away in a really dangerous spot.
Yeah, and that is very uncharacteristic. They just need to stay composed. I think they just lost their composure a little bit. And the passes obviously are not finding feet at all. And you need to be careful because Utah has the momentum right now.
So a corner from the attacking right that Hickson will take. Right-footed and bending out high to the top of the six. Caught by Sabrina Davis, who takes a knock in midair. Heads may have collided there. A Ute player is down. Sabrina down as well. Clock is stopped. It's an injury stoppage. 43rd minute, and trainers out for both sides. As Sabrina Davis went high to catch that corner, bodies collided, and immediately two players to the ground. And who knows what this will mean for Sabrina, but she is in some pain, rolling to her hip. And who knows if this will end her half prematurely.
Head injuries, they're nothing to mess with, though. They want to be careful, and I don't think there was anything malicious there on either side. They were just going for the ball, and that happens in soccer. Head bonk.
Now, whether or not Jen's plan was going to be to sub out Davis at halftime, as she and Cassidy Smith have had a number of games where they have played alternating halves, this might indeed end the half early for Sabrina. Tough to speculate, but she's on her back with her hands on her head. And so Cassidy Smith, who's been the alternate with Sabrina game to game this season, is getting ready a little earlier than she might have expected. So she's warming up on the near touchline with Mac Young right now. So getting some keeper practice on the near team area as Sabrina Davis is being tended to. The Utah player hurt. Tavia Leachman is up and walking off the pitch with some assistance. This comes in the 43rd minute, referee immediately stopping play for the injury. 0-0, BYU and Utah. BYU's allowed six goals on the year. Four of the six have come in the first 45 minutes of play, and nothing yet allowed by BYU in this one. Huh. Best crowd of the season for a Ute soccer game this year. They've been averaging, well, they got 1245 in their lone home game, but I think they'll do better than that tonight. Their away games, they just played three straight away games. The average there was under 600 for those three. And a really nice crowd on hand for this Friday Night Lights feature, BYU and Utah at Ute Soccer Field, and Sabrina Davis is being helped off the pitch. And, yeah, she will be quite the worse for wear as trainer Carolyn Billings has her locked by the arm and supporting her. And Sabrina wants to test stop. And have a word, take a breath, take a pause here. She was walking off and just stopped her path and will now make it off the pitch, not looking great. And so Cassidy Smith is in. Keeper substitution for BYU. Cass is in, and Sabrina Davis is out after taking a knock, midair collision, handling a corner. And, it doesn't look all there and all right now.
So unfortunate, because Sabrina was playing so well.
Yeah, she was quite in control and was asked to do a lot so far. Yeah. 5 shots on goal by Utah of their 6 taken total. And, again, some of them were in really difficult spots for the keeper to have to handle. Giveaways deep in the third. And Sabrina handled them all quite well. Utah coming into tonight at 18 shots on goal in 4 games, so roughly, you know, 4 and a bit per game, and they've already surpassed that here in the first half of this game. So Utah playing some of its more inspired offensive soccer this year, and they've had the shots advantage and shots on goal advantage as well.
Both
so
teams.
Cassidy Smith is in for BYU, and we'll restart this with a goal kick here in the 43rd. You're saying, Paige, both teams...
I say both teams are just struggling to put the ball in the back of the net. They both have created some opportunities, but they just can't get that final touch.
The better looks have probably been to Utah here in the first half.
Yes, for sure.
McKaylee Moore runs into a brick wall named Leah Gorder. Utah wins the ball. Gorder drives it into the Utes attacking half, long and left. Christensen running to it, won't get there before Alyssa Jefferson does. Jefferson will play to Cassidy Smith, a one-touch play out. A misplay by BYU. Cassidy's tried to get rid of it. Just skied it over the boundary. So it's a throw-in for Utah here in the 44th minute. We're almost at halftime here at Ute Soccer Field. Jen Rockwood, I think, wanted to know what that play was.
Yeah.
You had time and space, and Cass just blasted it into touch. It gives Utah a throw in the final third. The throw goes into the 18. It hops into the 6. Ball still loose. Utes possessing near the byline. You see it crawl over to be a goal kick for BYU. So again, simple little throw-in, but bounced around, pinged around the 18, then the 6, and Utah generating at least a look there.
What a throw. That throw went into the 18.
Cassidy Smith, another goal kick here in the 44th. 90 seconds to go till halftime. BYU looked pretty confident first 15 minutes, and not so much last 20 to 30.
That's been their story this whole season. Strong first 15 minutes, and kind of get frustrated when they can't put one in.
Throw-in for BYU. Ball step will take to Coulihan. Out off of BYU, Utah throw, defensive third for the Utes in the 45th minute. Final 60 seconds here at Ute Soccer Field. Holly, 45 seconds remain, still no throw. Off of Hickson, step up by DeGurda. DeGurda sends Fairbairn down the left wing. Fairbairn did not keep it in. It's out for a BYU throw, and with 30 seconds to go, not much left to do here in the first half. 0-0. Cougars and Utes in the 31st all-time meeting between these two sides. BYU the heavy advantage in the series, but this one's all even. Foul on Utah with 10 seconds to go.
Oh,
Coulihan restarts to Ballstedt. Ballstedt plays to Utah's back line. Off a deflection to Moore. Moore to Hickson. Hickson will drive it to the center line. That will end the half. We've gone through 45. 0-0 on the hill. So, BYU. I think the run of play for the first 10 to 15 minutes, and then Utah answered smartly and could reasonably say they carried most of the rest of the first half. We'll have halftime stats and analysis coming up after this break at halftime at Ute Soccer Field. It is Utah 0, BYU 0. This is BYU Women's Soccer on the new skin, BYU Sports Network.